Hello and welcome to Building Crow-T Robot. He's a little more complicated than Servo, but let's take a look at what you'll need. Super glue, two floraliers, Empire Crown bowling pins, a hockey mask, and a vacuum form soap dish. We're also going to need ping pong balls, wide elastic ribbon, string, black nylon string, and a flexible ringed rubber tubing. Here's the shoulders in a close-up shot. The pin, the hands, some PVC, the tubing, some elastic string. Now we also need soap dish, ping pong balls. You're going to need the arm replicas, the Plastruck square stock, copies of the hands, foam insulation, and some yard drain tubing. There's the nylon string I use. Let's talk about the PVC. You're going to need 200 PSI PVC connectors. Both half inch and three quarter. Here is the half inch PVC Schedule 40 600 PSI. It's very thick. It's not flexible whatsoever. And this fits cleanly inside the thin walled 200 PSI three quarter inch PVC. This is much thinner. You'll see how the piece fits right down inside. Spins freely, no binding. And then inside that, finally, well, here's a straight connector, half inch. These are one of the stops that will ride on the PVC. And inside that goes a half inch diameter Plastruck tubing, plastic tubing. That's what I use. First, let's go to his torso. It's going to be based on the two floraliers. Here's one. If you haven't gotten any of these, you can get them on eBay pretty easy. I have them if you need them. Anyway, you'll peel off these top pieces. I guess the flowers used to go in there, but save these rings. As you can see later, we cut out the center grid section, and those go back on the bottoms of the vases to make a nice protective bumper. So this thing snaps apart. I think it's five pieces. Pop it apart. Okay, there we go. All right, I'm going to be using a 1 1/4 inch keyhole saw. And I've made a small pilot hole, and I drill this straight through. You'll see this will make an opening. This same keyhole saw, 1 1/4 inch, I use on both inside vases. Now these are pretty rough cuts. You're going to have to clean these up a little bit. And here's the final large vase. I use an X-Acto knife. It's kind of a dull X-Acto knife. It's not super sharp. And I just scrape till it's nice and smooth. I use a piece of 3/4 inch PVC to slide in and out to make sure it fits. There. Same with the top one. Those two snap together, and the base tray goes on top of both bottom vases. Make sure it's centered. And then I'm going to drill three holes that go down through the vases, as well as the bottom tray. And then I'm just using some 1 1/2 inch drywall screws. Drive those down through the bottom tray and both vases. And this secures the whole thing together really well. Now here's the top tray. Again, I'm scraping this. This one you're gonna have to scrape a little bit bigger because you're gonna try to fit this 3/4 inch straight connector in here. If it's a little tight, I have a good tool I use called the persuader, and it has to be flush with the top here, you can see. Now, these floraliers are kind of a weird, strange plastic. I use a Scotch-Brite pad to take the shine off of it. That way this bulldog adhesion promoter works really well and makes the paint stick to this weird kind of plastic. It works really well. It's very flammable, be careful. It's lacquer based, so it sort of etches into the plastic. And here's the Floralier with its first coat of adhesion primer and cheap gold spray paint. And then a couple of coats of the Tester's Lime Gold. And here's a view of primer, then cheap spray paint, then multiple coats of the Tester's Lime Gold. Probably about 8 to 10 coats. Looks really clean and shiny that way. Alright, you need to glue this PVC to the inside connector. I use an actual super glue for this, but you can use a few of these other glues. There's a Contex cement, there's an actual PVC glue, and here's super glue. So I just put a little on the tip. This is an 18-inch piece of 3/4-inch 200 PSI PVC. Coat the end liberally and press this down inside the connector. Next, I'm going to be attaching the 4-inch wide yard drain to the inside top lid of the Floralier. I lay down some hot glue on a pre-drawn line so I know when it's centered. And you'll see, just press it into place and hold it there. Now also, sometimes you'll notice I'm using a completely painted set of Floraliers to show you, and sometimes still the white ones. Both of these are just to give you better ideas of how it's done as it's finished, and like I'm showing you here. This is a completely painted one that I'm doing the same thing to. I add my hot glue, I add my yard drain, make sure it's down inside the drawing I have, press in place, and hold till dry. Now let's look at the lamp shoulders. On the top lid and bottom lid of the Floralier, mark 2 1/4 inches from each end. That makes marks at 2 inches. That's where you're going to drill your holes for the Floraliers. Here you can see I'm drilling them into the resin bodies of the shoulder pieces and blow away the stuff. And I use the gold anodized short screws. They're about 1/4 inch long. It's enough to hold these in place and hold the two Floralier halves together as well. There you can see on a finished one. Here they are on our non-finished piece, so when you attach them, you can see everything's starting to look like it should. There's the base. There's our two top and bottom half of an 18-inch piece of 3/4-inch 200 PSI coming in from the bottom and held in place. I found these guitar stands work really well. They're adjustable. The opening at the top holds the bottom of Crow's Floralier in place perfectly. Okay, you need a 23.5-inch piece of the 1/2-inch PVC with a straight connector on the bottom. This slides up in through the throat that you've already built together into your body, and you can see how it spins freely. Now we're going to take a mark right here and take another straight connector and cut a 1/2 inch of it off and put a slot in the front, sand this down so it's smooth. This slides right over that 1/2-inch PVC, and you can see it makes a nice smooth neck. The hole in it allows for the strain to go through later. Now let's talk about our bowling pins. There.
Just ram that moldy olive loaf into your loser face.
Can't believe I have to wash Satan's towels.
I'm worried that my sandwich may be small and inadequate.
Now, I'm confused. Am I Chocolate Jones or Sugarfly McQueen?
You're both. And you're also reading the part of Sweet Mama Stringbean, who runs the Boutique de Beauté.
This is a story of a robot named Crow. Can you guess what Crow is thinking? Crow is thinking hard, or as hard as he can think anyway, on how the satellite got so darn clean. It wasn't clean this morning. Think hard now, Crow. Think really hard, you poor dope. Scan that scrap heap you call a brain and try to find some piteous shred of thought or
knock it off.
Yeah, keep on trucking, I guess. I guess you'll do your thing and I'll do mine. Yep, whip inflation now. Bye.